Today, we're going to be tying the Henryville Caddis. This fly can be tied from a size 12 right down to a size 18. The material that we'll need for this is some Grizzly saddle, some green 4-strand floss, some wood duck, a brown saddle, and some gray tying thread. To get started, I've got a size 14 dry fly hook in the vise, and I'm going to tie the thread in at about 3/4 up the shank of the hook. I do this, I tie it in at about 3/4 to properly proportion the fly, and that leaves me plenty of room for a nice head on the finished fly. The first thing we're going to tie in is our Grizzly hackle feather, and I've got a little bit of it stripped out there, and you want to leave a little portion of the stripped end of the hackle just past the bend of the hook. Go ahead and tie that in. And once we have that cinched down, we're going to go ahead and tie in a 4 or 5 inch piece of the 4-strand green floss. And you can change the color of this fly, just change the floss. You could use orange, brown, whatever you want to imitate the naturals on the water. We're going to tie that in with a nice soft loop at the bend. We'll do another soft loop in the middle and another one right at the tie-in point, and that'll cinch the floss down right on the top of the shank of the hook. Once we have that cinched down, we'll go ahead and clip off the excess material. And then we'll cinch down the rest of the floss, making a nice tight body. Go ahead and wrap the thread right back to the bend of the hook, and then back forward to the tie-in point. Now, to make a nice segmented body, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and twist that floss into a rope. If you're tying a smaller size fly, you could use 1, 2, or 3 strands of the floss. That way you don't have a big bulky body. As you wind forward, continue to give that floss a twist. It'll keep the structure of the rope intact and continue on with a nice segmented body. Wind that forward to the tie-in point of the thread, and then we'll go ahead and tie that off. Make a couple of wraps here, make it nice and tight. And then we could clip off the excess. The next thing we're going to do is palmer the Grizzly hackle through the body of the fly. We'll probably get 3 or 4 wraps on there. And as you're doing this, you may need to twist the hackle to keep the hackle fibers going in the same direction. Again, you want maybe 3-4 turns of the hackle here, wind it up to the tie-in point, and we'll go ahead and tie that off, and we can clip off the excess. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to trim off the top of the fly just a little bit, and that provides a nice base for the wood duck flank fibers, and we're going to take just a little slip of that as an underwing. Maybe 6-7 of those fibers there. And we're going to tie them in right on top of the shank of the hook with the tips extending just past the bend a little bit. We'll tie those in with a soft loop and cinch it down. Give it a couple of wraps to keep it in place and clip off the excess material. The next component is a mallard, is a couple of slips from a mallard flight feather, and we need 2 pieces from a matching feather, matching feathers that are about an 1/8 of an inch or so. And we're going to position those with the ends just slightly past the bend of the hook and on top of the shank, and we'll tie them down with a soft loop. Couple of soft loops there, and that'll position the mallard slips right on the top of the shank of the hook. You can see we got those positioned really nice on the top there. And we'll go ahead and clip the excess material off. And then we're going to tie in, we're going to wrap the head of that fly, cinch down the rest of the mallard slip and form a nice head. And wind the material, the thread back to the tie-in point. And then we're going to tie in our brown collar. And we're using some brown saddle feather here. You could use regular hackle, whichever you have. And again, leave a little bit of the stripped off saddle hackle past your tie-in point, and this will help you wrap a nice neat head. Go ahead and cinch that down and wind it just behind the eye. Clip off the excess. And then we're going to get four or five wraps of the saddle on here as a collar. And then we can tie that off and clip off the excess material. If you have any stray fibers floating around on the head of the fly there, you can clip them off. You want to make sure you've got a nice, neat head there and nothing obstructing the eye of the hook. We'll go ahead and whip finish this off. Put three or four wraps on there. Make it nice and tight. And if you so desire, you can put a little spot of head cement on the thread to keep it in place. Go ahead and clip the thread off, and that is your finished Henryville Caddis. Got any extra stuff floating around there, you can trim it up. This is a great fly. We fish this quite a bit on the beaver kill. This is a picture of Karen's pool, and when the caddis are coming off, it's a virtual snowstorm, and the fish take this fly very readily. Fish it dry right in the film, and you can even fish it wet as an emerging insect. Good luck. Let me know how you like the video.